Good day, guys. When I reviewed the Wonder Artistic Models Deluxe T-Rex, some of you sharp-eyed people noticed that when I opened the package, the T-Rex was not the only packet. I actually managed to squeeze in three models into the shipping fee, and today we'll look at the second. One thing I forgot to mention last time is that I really love how everything is done as best as can be. And even the packing paper is of good quality, and these seals have the WAM logo. Everything feels really premium. It almost feels wrong to cut into this, but there's no way to unpeel this, so that's what I have to do. I'm really excited to review this. As you can see, this is Ibrahim's 2020 model with that revised tail. It's got 159 pieces, so it's fewer than and perhaps a little easier to do than the T-Rex. The instruction sheet is just one page this time. Again, it's bilingual, so not an issue if you don't understand Spanish. Once again, you have the plates. They go from A, B, C, that's D, E, and F. Now, F is a little unusual, being completely unburnt, to make both sides the same color, since these tines are just going to be one layer thick. Finally, we have the G plate, with the skull and transverse processes of the tail. Assembly is pretty much the same, matching paired numbers. Now you see this piece here is number 2, so we'll locate here also number 2. And likewise here, this goes to C1, which will be piece number 1 on the C plate, and so on. And now we have this. Now the cervical ribs are shaped like this, with one side higher than the other, so that's the correct positioning for insertion. Now insert them according to which side is the presentation side. Now for myself, I'll make that the up face. Alright, so these were a little challenging to put in, but they're in now. And next we'll insert the other ribs. There we go. Now the gastralia. Now just note that these are not sequentially ordered. You see here is 2, and next 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, and so on. So it's not just putting them one after another. Now what I've done is to remove everything and order them. Or even, to be safer, is to push, attach, one by one so you don't get them mixed up. Now the reason for this is to create a kind of tapering shape in the gastralia, and yet having to fit it into one template. So we're going to do this now. And that's the gastral basket done. Now just to show you the rough form of the pectoral girdle with the arms and scapulae. And it's nice how because of the way these slot in here, you get neutral hands. And that's how it will go on. Alright, so let's remove this first. I'll attach the right humerus to the ribcage. Then the left humerus to the clavicle. Then to the ribs. And then we'll push in the right humerus in here. So you end up with something along the lines of this. And since these are very solidly fixed, I can just rest it like that. a try not to touch the cervical ribs. And these will go on last. Now just a note on the hind limbs. Now you see the chevron above this hole? And that's where this piece goes through. And then here you see the chevron also, and this piece goes in there. On either side you have 5 and 6, where these parts 5 and 6 go. Likewise here on either side of this chevron, 7 and 8. So it should be quite straightforward. Now the rear half of the sail, you see the F0 here? Well, where's that? Right here. F0. This one here is going to go into here. That's going to go to the one here. 2 here is going to here, and so on and so forth. So I'm going to take care of that right now. Now here, before fixing this, it would be a good idea to attach these here. Now first on one side, then the next. The final rib will go into the slot formed by joining them. And now these are the transverse processes of the tail vertebrae. Now what you do is you line them up with these such that they line up with their corresponding spinal processes. This part is tricky, and you see this little hole here? And that's where these thin bits are going to fit. So be very careful. Now before you do that, try to push these pieces as close together as possible, and be very careful because these ones are quite delicate, and I was pretty clumsy and I broke this one here. So just be very careful how you do that. Now this is that piece that you need to be careful with here. After that, however, from G1 onwards, you don't need to worry, because all you have to do, push these two pieces without the thin protruding piece, so they should be sturdy enough to put in. Now make sure you support the model at the strongest part, while putting the other side piece in. Now sight from the dorsal surface to align them properly. Now a quick note about the leg. This peg here, where we had the chevron, is a bit thick to push in, so that's where you can sandpaper it down. Now that we have it in, we affix the other toes on either side. There, that looks really good. Now the hole here, the way it's cut, allows you to put the femur in any orientation you want, so you aren't limited to just one position. And now the head. The anchoring piece here says up, so that's the presentation side on top. Now what you do is you fit the other parts of the skull onto this. Fit was very tight on mine, so I had to sandpaper it, and you do that from the bottom, so you avoid ruining this very nice presentation side here. Here we see the scleral ring. This slot points backwards. So here's the correct position. And then you slip it through. And just look at how nice that already starts to look. Now here are the other pieces fitted onto the anchor piece, and now just attached to the neck. So, there's the final model, and I think you can see how wonderful it looks. The only thing I'd say is that these stands need to be carefully balanced, and I put some blue tack at the bottom to make them more secure. The head can articulate from side to side. You remember I talked about this interesting cut here, which means you can put it any way you want, but I've chosen to replicate the position of the Ibrahim 2020 paper schematic, and you can see just how exacting it is here. And this is a whopper. It's 70 centimeters or 27.6 inches long and about 1 to 22 scale. Now comparing to the Wonder Artistic Models T-Rex, I think you can appreciate the difference in length here. The PNSO Ibrahim Spinosaurus. And finally, the GR Toys, which as you can see look really nice together. Swimming means you avoid the awkwardness of the hand positions here. There are also two holes here with thread provided that allow you to hang the model from the ceiling. Very thoughtful. Now those of you who are keenly interested in Spinosaurus have probably read the paper a few times, and this diagram is doubtless very familiar to you. I really like this schematic. And even though there are issues with the aquatic predator theory, I really like the look of it. After all, it's the closest thing we'll ever have to something that looks like a real dragon with wings. And you can see just how, like with the 2020 Spinosaurus, the tail is as much a star as the sail. And here, of course, the characteristic M shape of the sail is there. And here's the crazy thing. You'll see that Wonder Artistic Models has captured not only every single spine, all 15 of them, but each is exactly the same shape. Now, crazily enough, it's the same for the tail, but I'm not crazy enough to count them. And so, not only does this model give you the latest reconstruction in the 2020 paper, it gives you a replica of this, dare I say, very iconic diagram. And given how significant this paper is in the long saga of Spinosaurus, this model is really a manifestation of that. And this is overall a very happy result. Once again, another winner from Wonder Artistic Models. And these are really unique products for the serious collector. And so far, the two I've reviewed definitely attest to that. Now, just for fun, have a look at their website that I'll link to below and make a guess. Which dinosaur did I get for my last model? I don't think it'll be too hard to guess actually, and hopefully soon I'll show you what that third one was. I'll see you soon in the next video.